Welcome back, guys. This is episode 52 of Ender LP, and yep, this is video 100. And at the point I'm recording this right now, we're at 80 something subscribers and 80k views, so that's very nice. And we're only at episode 52, at the top of the world. But, yep. It's ready. We have efficiently completed building the EnderCity. It is finished. Just a few touches missing, but the main building part of it, it's all done. So right now we're in the fourth circle, the last one. I just finished building this, and yeah, we had to change some stuff around because when I planned to build this, I had no idea that, 1.3 just came out, so we had no idea about 1.4, and I actually had to change the stuff around now, because soon we're going to have potatoes and carrots, and we're going to need a separate farm for that too, because this is just wheat. So, I replaced the lily pads with half slabs, even though they don't let light through, since wheat is, instant breaking. You can also instant break the lily pad, so if you hit the lily pad it will break and then it just makes a mess. It's a lot easier with this. Just go over it without trampling anything and it's good. So this is gonna be our potato and pumpkin farm. I'm gonna try to make this shorter than usual because sometimes it gets too long. I'm just gonna show you guys what I got done. Progress reports on our Ender City. Half potatoes, half carrots. The water source blocks are under this. We got lighting around the edges, which I think is enough. Been working on this for a while, our wheat sugarcane farm. Missing a few over here. Also planted this not a long time ago, but yeah, I think this is the most efficient system. I've been trying different styles, and this is the most efficient one, which is I think at 75%, yeah, for every water block for those. So that's good. This is gonna be our mycelium and grass farm. I'm not completely sure yet because I wanted to have one of those could be carrots and this could be potatoes, but then we wouldn't have a place to put mycelium grass to grow. So, I'm not sure about this one yet. We might find a different place to grow the grass and mycelium, such as possibly on the ceiling, on the roof of our buildings, since it's just flat and there's nothing up there. And we don't need water sources to grow it too, so that's another thing that we have to figure out. But yeah, I'll just do that another time. Yeah, I'm not sure if mobs can spawn on tilled dirt or on wheat, because apparently there they can, but not here. Yeah. Fail. What's up there? In our huge mountain. In the end, it did fit. We had no problems, and actually there's a very nice little window over here, where if this loads, you'll actually see the mountains in the background. There we go. Yeah. Kinda a neat hole over here. And yeah, it was very close to the edge actually. Very close. But it fits, so that's good. Alright, next thing we're gonna go check out is our other farms, I think. I've been working on the mine a little bit. I'm too lazy at the moment to replace all the walls with smooth stone, but I might do that some other time. Yeah, been breeding these guys. Cows, sheep. We got two double chests full of eggs now with our little chicken family over here. Our stuff's growing pretty good, and I think I might put another chest over on that side with the hose in it, because we don't really need it here. It's mostly over there where we have to walk around and plants. because those farms don't need to be tilled. So yeah, still haven't dug out that slime chunk yet. I'm not sure what I'm waiting for, maybe when I feel like it or something. But I'm just gonna have to be dug up from the bottom, because slime spawn layer 30 and down, and we are gonna do it the same style we had in the village, just a bit different. I'm gonna make it larger, on 3 on each edge, and we're gonna make it on automatic killing slime farm. So they drop down and they take fall, I think they take fall damage, and or if they don't, we can just kill them ourselves. But I'm gonna have the water streams just to pick up all their items and to bring them to one spot so we can go AFK there, and we'll just constantly be getting slime balls. So that's also something I want to do. Waiting for the beacon blocks from there. And there's been a few things that have changed in the Nether. So yeah, currently we have another person that just joined our Ender server, Endercraft, whatever it is, I got no idea anymore. His name's Poison, Poison Dark Frog, and he used to be, I used to play with him on a different server, the Cindycraft, which I don't really go on anymore. But yeah, so he wanted to come over, and here he is. He's also built some pretty cool stuff, so I'll show you guys that too. At the village, I built something at the Helix, because we had no portals there. So what I did is I put a portal at the Helix, and we made it a trading post. So if you have anyone who has like spare items and they don't need anything, they can just go there, throw it into the chests over there, and if you need something, such as maybe seeds or something, something random that's obviously not diamonds, then you can always just go there, see if someone has left some over there, and you can just take it. So yeah, I'm gonna leave these beds over there because I have no need for them anymore. So yeah, let's go hop over there and see what it is. So here's the village portal, that's to the iron golem farm and other stuff, and this is to, wait, darn it, someone. Alright. It's really close actually, that's why I didn't put rails. It's right here to the Ender trading post. And here we are at the Helix. Two portals. Our Ender egg is still over there, haven't moved it yet. Welcome to the Ender trading post. This is a public give and take donation bin. Have any spare shit? Leave it here. Need something? Take what you want. Please do not take too much. Yeah. So we have bows. I needed one of these. Arrows. This looks like someone took the arrows. I had a double chest there full. Weapons, tools, armor. Yep. Useless stuff, random stuff, and block items, food items. Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna leave this in the random stuff chest. And yeah, that's everything here. Nothing has really changed here. Nothing, nothing, nothing. So yeah, I'm gonna hop over to Poison's house, show you guys some stuff over there. He's not on at the moment. No one's on at the moment. And yeah, it's kind of far, so I'll just cut it. Okay, I also wanted to show you guys this portal to Surtert's man cave. Seems like to decorate his tunnel that goes over there. That's fine with me. If he gets griefed, it's not my problem. But I hope we don't have griefers on this server, so yeah, I think he's changed some stuff there, so actually let's go here first, because it's a lot closer. Yeah, he said he's changed a lot of stuff in his house, and yeah, last time we went there it was quite different. So let's see, what's he changed from the front to the back? Okay, here's the entrance. Nothing there. Center to mine cave. He removed the chests that were here. Still got the furnaces here. Railway. We're using the rail in another, so it's not like he needs this anymore. Ooh, minecarts. See, wheat farm. Apparently not very efficient, from what I can tell. And much smaller than ours. Sleeping quarters, and we pick up. Chanting room, you don't need that many bookshelves. Portal room. Mullen farm. We didn't have this last time. Is it piston activated? No, it's not. Cocoa bean farm. Manual as well. Oh well. Pretty good. Ours is more efficient, though. Fountain in the middle. That's very nice. I like how he did this. It seems to have an... Oh my god. No! I lost some stuff. I can't remember what, though. I think it was some sticks. Armor. Armor's gone. All of it. Wow. Stupid lava. You're gonna pay for this. You're gonna pay. But what is this? Why? Why do you have a tunnel that goes all the way down and just kills you? How stupid is that? Oh my god, this is ridiculous. Well, for that, I'm gonna take your coal. Wow, that's a deep hole. I wonder why he would do something like that. Darn it. Just in case, I'm not gonna do that again. Nope, not today. Alright. Well, that made me think maybe he did that as a safety measure. To, in case he had to run away or something. That would actually be pretty good if he'd only put water breaks on it. But that made me think that could actually be pretty useful as an escape. You have water breaks, and when you hit the bottom, there's pressure plates that hit some pistons and close off the water so that if someone jumps in after you, they will go straight down and die. That would actually be very smart. But yeah, obviously. Ooh, nether wart. Pickup. That's very nice. Replant. Very nice. Pumpkin patch. Same as melons. Not very efficient. I guess this could go to more. Could. Alright, and here's a storage room. Which looks like a mess. It's horrible and it's just... Oh my god. Well, maybe I should get myself some better... Whoa. Fire protection. I'll take the bad armor. Just because he owes me one. Aqua affinity. Yeah, just take that. That's worse. Alright, there we go. Suit up again. He's got like basically one chest for one chest for everything. Which is actually in a very small space. It's very efficient the way he did it, but it's not very nice. I like mine better. Well, just a bit better. Not to brag, but this is a pretty cool house. I really like the style he's using for this. And yeah, let's see if that monument we saw last time we came here is still there. I'm not... Well, this wasn't here last time. Wow. That's huge. What is this? Oh my god. Alright. Well, I guess we'll see soon enough what it is. And, oh, don't fall. I see ladders over there. What is this? Oh. Alright. Alright. As I was saying, I just got a call from Dexstar529, and he says he's gonna come over, maybe we can record together a little bit, so I'm just gonna end it here, and then I guess we'll take a look at Poison Dart Frog's house later. I have no idea what this hole in here is supposed to be. House entrance is right over there. Over here is his monument thing, which I'm not sure what he called it. I still don't know what he called it. Oh, hey there, spider. Go to hell. So yeah, Dexstar is going to be coming over soon. And let's see if Sittard has added anything here. If not, yeah, I'm just going to wait for Dexstar to get over here. I have no idea what that is. He has nothing in here. Oh, that's getting fixed at 1.4, so yeah. Awesome. Oh yeah, I took some redstone ore that was down there. Always carry a silk touch pick with me now. Just because ore is always nicer. Especially for diamonds. Alright. So yeah, I think that's it for Sutterd. Those are all the updates on his house. Everyone else is still working on theirs. Bloody Moody Woody has no significant updates on his house. That thing's getting huge. And but yeah, Poison Dart Frog has actually done quite a lot in the first few days he's been here, so I'm gonna show you guys what he's done there. And yeah, I guess I'll be back with Dexstar. Oh yeah, and one last thing. Before Dexstar comes over, I wanted to show you guys this. I had some extra stacks of spare iron blocks, and I've started making the paths full iron like I wanted to in the first place. Now I think we only have less than a stack of iron left. I had like 5 stacks of blocks. Yeah. But yeah, this is how I want it to be in the end. I might move these closer, the redstone, glowstone, redstone lamps closer together to have more even lighting. But yeah, I think in the future, not right now, but in the future, we're gonna get rid of these. All these paths going between parallel paths going from circle to circle, I think we're gonna get rid of those. Just use a big cross in the middle and put iron blocks on the sides of that. Just because I think it would look neater than having a big square with circles and then a X, and then we have all different types of shapes in our Ender City, and I've already done triangles, so triangles and circles is enough. I'm gonna get rid of these, not right now, because it would take a long time to get rid of it and then make it all perfect and stuff. But yeah, that's a future project, and next episode I hope that we can work on the villager spawners, if possible. The infinite villager spawner, yeah. That, or something to go into those houses, those buildings, because they're empty. So, yep, I'm waiting for Dexstar. Alright, so Dexstar's here. Say hello.
Hi.
Yeah, and in case you're wondering, efficiency of our wheat farm is 5 stacks per harvest.
Ooh.
Plus 3 stacks of seeds, on average. So,
why do you need all that wheat?
For breeding. And, I'm not sure about the sugar cane. I'm gonna have to let that grow. So right now, we're gonna hop over to, Poison Dart Frog's house. And I'll meet you guys there.
What the hell is that?
That's Ew!
This is gross. Who did this to my end portal?
Look up at the ceiling. There's...
I put the cobblestone there. This used to be just a cobblestone.
Can you explain to me why do you have bedrock up there?
Because we're at the ceiling of the Nether, man.
Really?
Yeah.
The Nether has a ceiling?
Yeah. Of course it does.
I
see we're at 120. But yeah, that's a really bad mix with the lapis and the... I wonder who did that. And they also removed the sign that said to the...
To my butt.
Nether fort. I mean, to the end portal. Oh, well. Continue on our journey. Alright, so we're arriving now. This is...
That was 30 seconds from the last edit.
I know it was. But that's 30 seconds shorter than it is. Alright, let's check this out. Alright, so this is Poison Dirt Frog's house, base,
poop thing.
Portal over here. He said this was an automatic wheat farm, 40 wheat per minute, with bone meal, seeds, and wheat. I have no idea what this is. Very small sugarcane farm over here.
Sugarcane farm? What?
Sugarcane.
Oh.
Ours is a bit more efficient. Well, a lot more efficient.
You're gonna make like a million books or something? Or like make
Lot
of cocaine?
I need to finish my library.
Library.
So that's a nice design with the leaves and the logs. Two diamond door up there.
What happens if I light it on fire?
You shouldn't do that, because it's griefing. Very nice design on the floor.
Holy crap, I'm gonna get high off of this.
And... Yeah, that looks actually really cool with the snow and ice.
Ooh. I'll break one and everything is gonna, like, melt.
No, it doesn't melt. It only melts if you put light inside.
What? The torches!
I know. Yeah, but they're farther away that they won't melt. He's missing some brown wool here.
Some poop wool.
And... I'm not sure I like this combination of colors. That looks weird.
Is that supposed to be a portal?
No, that's like a design, I think.
That looks like a portal
with
design.
Blue and obsidian.
Yeah.
Anyways, he's really new, and that's quite a lot to get done in just a few days. So probably soon it will get much more expanded, lots of more stuff coming. And he's obviously a very unorganized person.
You're not disorganized, you're talking about Thomas at the moment. Or scapegoat for...
Oh yeah, his house is a mess, but... Still working on it, don't worry.
What did you do that for?
I don't want to fall in there.
That looks ugly now!
It's okay, it looked ugly before anyways.
Oh, ew.
Record
you traveling!
I think there's an issue in the game with,
My butthole.
Minecarts. When I got out of the minecart, it was right here. And now it's gone.
You just pushed it.
Oh, it's invisible, I guess. Yeah, that's the glitch. It goes invisible for, like, several seconds while it's in the nether. And if it doesn't move, if you move it, then I think it updates.
Oh, cool.
But, yeah, that's very confusing. And I'm losing lots of minecarts.
Just put all my shit in the ground.
Alright, anyways. So, I think that's it for exploring other people's houses for this episode.
Explore mine.
Oh yeah, that's something we should do. Let's go over to your house. Alright, so here's Scapegoat's house.
So he's hollowing out the
mountain. Still in progress, yeah.
He's hollowing out the mountain.
That's a big hole he's got in there.
Whoa.
Oh my god. Oh well, it's really messy in there, so we're not gonna go in there. He doesn't want people going in his house until it's ready. So...
Too bad, I've already gone in there a million times.
I know, but like everybody else. Oh well. So, let's...
Ew!
This is your house, right?
Yes.
In progress.
Ew. It looks ugly, uncompleted.
It's okay.
It's gross.
You'll finish it soon. Alright, so that's very huge. Very large, too.
Nothing compared to yours.
But like...
Oh, you didn't read the signs!
Alright.
I think some people will know.
One side's name is Ib. One side is Mary.
And in the middle is me. No.
Alright, so this is a cool bridge you got over here.
Yay.
Dexter 529's house, obviously, in progress. And stuff is in the basement. I don't really like this stairs. It's too bouncy.
It's too
right,
bouncy.
Let's see, food and ingredients. You're running low on food. You got lots of diamonds.
Ooh.
Box. Items and equipment. A bucket. A bucket and torches. Nice.
Some equipment.
Alright, so this is just under that bridge thingy. These are the stairs that go beneath.
And show them your gobble generator thingy.
There's space around the house.
I don't know what those are for. I might
do. And this is a work area, so...
Actually, that's your work area, more likely.
Welcome to the new and improved stone generator by Ender. I actually modified this recently, and...
Ew, glitchy block.
It's a lot faster now. See, the piston just extends and retracts instantly. So, yeah, it's a lot more efficient.
Do you want to show them the contraption
faster.
Underneath?
You
don't got stone.
Yeah, sure. Let's see.
Wrong area. Oh, never mind.
Alright, so here's the... I think this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... This is a 9 clock.
You passed math.
It is a 9 clock, and there's a pulse shortener over here with an inverter that goes to the torch and powers the piston, so every pulse gets shortened, and that way the water has a longer time to turn into stone. And yeah, it's a lot smaller than it used to be. I used to have redstone all the way until here with like a 17 clock or something, which was ridiculous.
I still do not understand your theory of how lava on top of running lava on top of running water is stone, but something else is cobble and the other thing is the obsidian.
Okay, so...
Explain to us, please,
Lava
Ender.
Goes on top of a water source, it turns to stone.
That's not on a water source, though. That's a water running thing.
No, because there's water on both sides of this block over here. So
oh, okay.
It makes a water source, and it turns to stone when the lava goes on it.
Oh, cool.
If water goes on a lava source, it turns into obsidian. Such as lava pools, you pour water, it turns to obsidian.
Okay.
And if running water hits running lava...
It makes cobblestone!
Yes, and stone is a lot faster to mine, so...
I can't tell the difference. You're using the silk touch.
Yeah. You can get stone this way, too.
Yeah, but I don't have enchanted items.
No, but once you do, you can just use it to get stone. And, yeah, it generates a lot faster now. You can just go AFK here.
I need that, because my center pillar needs a lot more stone brick!
Alright, well then you can make more stone brick.
Oh, hey, cool.
And...
Don't you dare.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're welcome.
Wow! Thank a lot.
Stone brick cube.
Ew.
So,
Great. Thanks.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I can't wait to see the house when it's finished.
That's gonna take a while.
And... Don't worry, my house took longer than yours did.
Yours is not even a house. You shut your mouth. Yours is like a freaking...
It's a spaceship.
City. It's like a spaceship city thingy.
Yeah.
I'm still... What am I gonna say? Damn it.
Shh. Alright, anyways. I think that's all I have for this episode. Just to make it shorter, because usually they get a bit too long.
How long has it been?
Around... less than half an hour, I think.
How do you know if you're still recording?
Don't ask stupid questions.
Kill All the right, chicken.
So
I would like the chicken. Kill it. Kill
I'll
it.
Be back soon.
Kill the chicken!
See you guys soon.
No, okay. Hello, I have taken over Mr. Enderman. Alright, let's check out his area now. What is here?
Ooh.
Ew. What's up with your lighting? That's gross. let's keep running. There's dirt here. There's poop here. Oh, let's see here. Fix it. Now what's with these crops? He said it would produce 3 stacks. 3 stacks. I wonder. Are you sure 3 stacks? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.